Welcome to this presentation entitled Introduction to the Discrete Phase Model, or DPM, in Ansys Fluent. In this video, you will learn how to set up a simple DPM run in Ansys Fluent. The Discrete Phase Model is a numerically compact multi-phase model where the secondary phase is modeled as sources and or sinks of mass, energy, and momentum, and the Navier-Stokes equations are solved only for the primary phase. It is useful for modeling liquid droplets in a gas, or gas bubbles in a liquid, as well as inert particles in a gas or a liquid. In this demonstration, liquid droplets are injected at the inlet of a spray tank. Let's look at our model boundary conditions. So we have two inlets. We have a cold air inlet at the bottom of the spray tank. The velocity is 5 meters per second, and the temperature is 20 degrees C. We also have four tangential hot air inlets, as you can see here. The velocity there is 10 meters per second, and the temperature is 200 degrees centigrade. The outlet is a pressure outlet with zero gauge pressure, and all the walls are adiabatic. At the cold air inlet, we will inject 1 millimeter water droplets. The injection velocity will be 7 meters a second. The mass flow rate will be 0.001 kilograms per second, and the droplet temperature will be 25 degrees C. Now here we are in the Fluent interface. I have launched a 3D and double precision Fluent run. Anytime that you have multiphase and the energy equation, it is recommended that you run double precision. Okay, now let's look at our model here. Okay, here's our cold air inlet. Here are four tangential hot air inlets. There's our outlet. Okay, so now let's set up our models. First, we will start by turning the energy equation on. I'll also turn on the species model. Species transport, turn off diffusion energy source. Okay, let's look at our materials. Let's look at our default mixture template species. Let's remove O2 and N2 and add air. Okay, we'll leave the density as incompressible ideal gas as our velocities are pretty low. For heat capacity, we'll do mixing law, which is a default. Thermal conductivity, we'll do ideal gas mixing law. For viscosity, we will do the same. We'll leave the mass diffusivity at 2.880 to the minus 5, which is a default that should be appropriate for the temperature and pressure range that we're working in. Now let's set up the discrete phase model. So we will double click here on discrete phase. Click here on interaction with continuous phase. Then click on injections. And let's create a new injection. As you can see, argon liquid showed up here as the material. We want it to be water liquid, and the evaporating species is H2O, which is water vapor. Okay, the injection type will make surface, and they'll be released from the cold inlet. Okay, as I said, 7 meters per second inlet velocity, diameter. That's 1 millimeter. Temperature 25 C will be 298.15, mass flow rate 0.001. Let's click OK for now. And there's our new injection. Now let's study this discrete phase model panel in detail. So in order to define injections, I had to turn on this interaction with continuous phase. If you look here at DPM iteration interval, this tells you that there will be one DPM iteration for every 10 continuous phase iterations. So this is a steady state analysis. So the flow field will be computed steady state, but every 10 iterations, there will be an injection of the water droplets. As I said in the introduction, the water droplets will exchange mass, energy, and momentum with the continuous phase, which is the air in this case. So the droplets will evaporate, generating water vapor, and this water vapor will propagate through the domain based on the boundary conditions and operating conditions of the model. Okay, the other thing to look at here is the max number of steps, it is usually better to specify the length scale. The default is 0.01. So if you multiply the max number of steps times the length scale, that is basically 500 meters. So the droplets will be tracked from the inlet for a total of 500 meters. In that time, they either will escape through the outlet, or they will completely evaporate, or they will be rendered incomplete. And at every 10 iterations, when the DPM iterations happen, you will see that in the display as to what is going on with the droplets every 10 iterations. Now let's do one thing that I forgot. Got to turn on turbulence model. I will use K omega SST. Hit OK. So now an important thing to look at when you have turbulence turned on, if you look at the injections, okay, and you go here under turbulent dispersion, you can turn on the discrete random walk model. Now what that does, as a default, when you do a surface injection, Fluent will inject a droplet at every cell in that face. So you don't have a lot of control unless you mesh judiciously as to how many droplets are going to be in the domain. So if you turn on the discrete random walk model, here you can do the number of tries. So the default is one. So it'll inject one droplet at every centroid on the inlet face. But let's say if you do 10, it'll inject 10 of them in the same spot. Now, discrete random walk model basically perturbs the path of each droplet based on the local randomized turbulence fluctuations. So it is a more accurate way of predicting the droplet trajectory than leaving that off. So it provides you with the ability to inject more droplets. And the more droplets there are, the less of a shock it is to the system whenever you inject and there's phase change, then the sources and sinks of energy and mass and momentum to the continuous phase are lessened when you have multiple sources and sinks, when you have more sources and sinks than just a single droplet at each cell face in the inlet. This concludes the DPM setup portion of this video. There's another video posted, which would be a continuation of this video, entitled DPM Solution Best Practices. Thanks for watching.